So now we're going to talk about displacement. Displacement is how far away an object is from where it was at the beginning. So if you have a car and your car starts out right here and it drives over there and then comes back again, then even though the distance you've traveled is this plus this, your displacement is only how far you are from where you started to where you are when you stop. We're used to thinking about distance traveled or displacement, which are the same thing whenever the vehicle is only going in one direction. So if we're going to talk about velocity, which we are in just a second, displacement and distance are the same whenever velocity is positive. Then we're used to talking about this distance or displacement as the antiderivative of velocity. We're used to being able to say that if we have a position function and we take its derivative, then we get a velocity function. But there's another way we can think about distance and velocity in time, and that's using a physics interpretation. So physics tells us that distance traveled, or displacement, is equal to velocity times time, or distance equals speed times time, you may have heard. Can we use this definition to help us find displacement? Well, it turns out we can. For example, if we know that your car was going 50 miles per hour for 2 hours, we can say that the distance you traveled is 50 miles per hour times 2 hours, which is 100. But if we give this a geometric interpretation, we can graph it and we can say, here's my velocity graph, v of t, it's 50, and I want to know v of t after 2 hours, then what I'm actually finding is the area of this rectangle right here, or the area under the velocity curve. And we can generalize this. If we say that you went, 50 miles per hour for 1 hour, and then you went, and then you started slowing down, and say you went 50 minus x miles per hour for, maybe we better make it 51 minus x so we get a pretty continuous function, for the second hour. Then our graph would look like this. Starts out at 50, and then it starts decreasing at 1. And if we wanted to know how far we had gone after 2 hours, then for the first hour, it's pretty easy to find the distance that has been traveled, or the displacement. You take distance equals rate times time, and you've gone 50 miles in the first hour. But for the second hour, it's a little bit more interesting. So you might want to, you might say something like, well, find the average speed that you went over that time. Or pick a point in that interval and say, well, let's just pretend we were going that speed the whole time. So maybe we look at the point, you know, 1.5 hours into our drive. And then we would say that our distance is, well, the velocity 1.5 in is 51 minus 1.5 times this length of time, which is 1. So this would be 49.5 times 1, which is 49.5. Or adding these together, we would say we've gone 99.5 miles in the 2 hours. But this would look familiar. In fact, what we just did here in the second rectangle is exactly a midpoint Riemann sum. And so what you want to notice here is that displacement is actually equal to the area under the velocity curve. And we can find it with Riemann sums.